So as I'm talking to you, I don't know the day, but Prophet T.D. Joshua will leave this world. I've given the prophecy. There is a day, mark me, Prophet T.D. Joshua, God is preparing him, and he will leave the earth. Listen to me. I was taken from this end to the sky and heaven open. As I stood in between earth and heaven, this is me. It's just like you're on a door and you can jump and I can fall on the head. And I'm looking at heaven. As I looked down, I saw six angels that were sent from heaven to go to the earth to collect Prophet T.D. Joshua. Listen well to me. I'm telling you only what I want. I will not say what I did not see. I saw the angels coming up like rocket. Three holding this his left hand. Three angels holding his right hand. Then he was like this. Three supporting his left. Three supporting his right. Do you know football cup? He was holding the cup, a trophy. And they were coming up with him. I was looking down like that. I said, wow. God have said they should come and carry Prophet T.D. Joshua. Look at how they are carrying his hand. I saw the cup he was coming to heaven with. As he entered heaven, I was looking now where those six angels were going. I saw the way to the right. I turned on my right. I saw a throne that was God's throne. I could not see the face. All over was light. And I heard the voice speaking from the throne. Take the trophy from him, bring it to me, and take him where he belongs. Another angels were on the throne, not the six. The six were still in his hand. Some other bigger angels, those were now cherubims, those who are at the throne of God. They left the throne too. They came now, they took the cup from Prophet T.D. Joshua's hand. They carried it to the throne of God. And the voice spoke, take him to his place. And the six angels, they were carrying him now to where he has inherited in heaven. And when I saw that, the heaven locked. I stood now, heaven was closed. I was in the air. The Holy Spirit brought me down. As I landed on earth, I just saw the sea. And a beast came out of the sea. And the Bible spoke to me. What you read in Revelation, this is what will what? Happen. After he will leave the earth, the Antichrist woke up. And I saw the beast came out, and the beast transformed into a prophet with a long garment. And the voice, he spoke to me, that is the false prophet. He was the true prophet. Even you, don't be deceived. The voice spoke to me. That is the false prophet. I started going behind. I said, Lord, we are finished. Is this how this world will end? Immediately, I saw a line. Thousands of men of God, prophet, apostle, pastor, evangelist, and demons stood with a bucket like bait. They deep inside. On man of God's forehead. 666. They are writing on men of God. As they are writing, I began shaking. Oh Lord. Would they write? They wrote until the line is not ending. Suddenly, they were through. I just saw three demons were in front of me. They said, what are you thinking? They were holding the bucket. They laugh. They say, we know what you are thinking. You are thinking in your heart that. Shall they write it on my head? Yes, oh no, they make to me like that. Oh no, we will not write it on your head, but be careful, we are watching at you. The least mistake you make, we will write it on your head. So as I'm talking to you, I don't know the day, but Prophet T.D. Joshua will leave this world. I've given the prophecy. There is a day, mark me, Prophet T.D. Joshua, God is preparing him. And he will leave the earth. And when he leaves, all this you have, Kwashoko Christianity you are making, is more dangerous for you. You who did not hold on to truth is worse for you. You go astray. You will not even know what is truth again, what is not what? Truth. You will not even know. Anything will be truth for you. And they mentioned to me, we are watching at you. The day you make an error, we'll write on your head. They just make it like you're mocking somebody. That fame and money. We are watching at you. And I brought up. I took my Bible, I wrote it. Pride, fame, money. That is why you see me getting humble every day.
Satan can go up and down.
He will not do anything with your salvation if you are obedient to Christ. That is the only grace and the highest grace you need.
Remember, the Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness. That is the most important. Every other thing shall go
added. Why forget about things? It means that's the most important thing for me to be able to seek first the kingdom of God. That's the most important thing.
So as I'm standing here, I know that hell is looking at me like this. As shepherd, God said, take care of the sheep over which I've made you what? Shepherd and overseer. Feed them.
This is the feeding I'm feeding you. Don't say I'm not feeding you. This is the food I'm giving to you.
What makes you a Christian is your commitment with Jesus. When that commitment is not there, you are not yet a Christian. For you to be a child of God is your commitment with Jesus. To hear what he says, to hear what he wants you to do, and for you to do it. That means you are a Christian. To hear what he says, to know what he wants you to do, and you what? Do it. That makes you